Yeah! down here from Brazil by the looks of things. We've got a few friends out here. Yeah. You be the loud, really nuts ones down the front here. The other fucking idiots over there smoking dope, you're here banging your fucking heads. That is what we like. Alright, we've got a lot of stuff tonight. It's actually been 25 years since we played MSG. 25 years was the first time we showed up here. If you look at all the pictures of all the people that are all around the walls, I saw a clown, I saw a couple of ice skaters, there was a gymnast who I can't remember the fucking name of, but there's no Iron Maiden there. It's weird, isn't it? It's funny how you come here for 25 years and they don't bother putting you up. It's because, my friends, Iron Maiden is not and never will be part of anybody's fucking establishment. So we have a little bit to live up to tonight. We're going to be playing songs off of Powerslave. We're going to be playing songs off of Seven Stone, off Subway and Time, all kinds of stuff for you. I know some of you have definitely not been to church today. This will have to do this evening instead, alright? However, the only Bible reading will be taking place in the bar later. Rime!
start again. Start with this song. Tonight, right. We could not get any more people in. If we could grow the place another 50%, we would, alright? Really sorry that we sold out as far as... Hello! You're the people that can't see. I've paid special attention to you this evening. And you! But they're always happy. Because I was addressed and directed. I mustn't forget people though, right? Everybody down the back. Everybody right the way down the back. Alright, yeah? In America, there's more people on this tour around the world seeing Iron Maiden than we've ever had in our entire lives during our entire career. And you need to know, in case you didn't figure it out already, the only reason we exist, the only reason that we are allowed to be up here doing what we do tonight is because of by kind permission of yourselves, my friends. TV, we never got any help from the radio, we never got any help from anybody. They all wanted to do mainstream bullshit, right? We've never been mainstream bullshit, and you know that, and we know that, and that's why we're all here to celebrate tonight, my friends. So if I want to sum up in two words, it will be to say the last 25 years. Come on.
tonight, my friends. Long way to go. Hope you're not feeling too tired, it being a Sunday night and all that. We're watching the television there. There's all kinds of sports takes playing on this show, isn't there? It's a funny game. Actually, we played a game of football the other day. What we call football, not what you call football. Your game of football. I learned something the other day. Watching football. American football. That's what we call what you call football. And how they sort of stand there like this. Making funny dog face, like they're about to take a shit. All steroid and oh no, they don't take steroids, do they? They're professional athletes, no, heaven forbid. But they do this funny thing that while they look, whilst it looks like they're taking a shit, they go, things like that. They take one hand, and I've noticed they put it behind their backs. Now this is very worrying up to a point, but I do understand it has a perfectly reasonable function, which I shall now demonstrate.
Ah!
behind your bulletproof glass and come down to join the rest of the great unwashed down here. Thank you. Very kind of you. If there was no roof on this place, I'm going to ask you, are there any bird watchers in the audience? I'm talking about birds that fly, ornithology, that sort of thing, so with two wings and claws and beaks. Anybody? See, people say that Iron Maiden is not a cultured audience. Who'd have thought there'd be a bunch of bird watchers in the audience? So the next question is, how many people here have ever heard of an albatross? Suddenly there are 12,000 ornithologists in the audience. Isn't that amazing? Anybody seen an albatross in New York? Well, maybe in a funny sort of restaurant served up with something else, but not actually as the seabird alive flying down the canyons. They tend to be pursued by ancient mariners in ships. And what we're all getting up to here is leading up to the epic poem by Samuel Taylor Coleridge, written 300-400 years ago. Day. All of our resources going to shit, all our ecosystems going to shit, maybe, but basically what he said in this poem was, if you don't look after what you've got, what you haven't got will come back and bite your ass, alright? But back in 1985, when we were doing, was it Long Beach Arena, Live After Death, I do believe? Something which you may be familiar. I said something else. I said, this is what not to do if your bird shits on you. The Rime of the Ancient Stop to the queen. The boys are the one, the boys are scared. The boys are the one.
was 15 living men, and I heard no sigh, no groan. And every time the light was up, they dropped down.
Yeah. for the one who just succeeded. We'll be right back.
besieged by the ghost of Shannon tonight. But I think we've blown away the wicked witch of the West. Shall we finish the, what should we do? Shall we finish the last course of Powerslave? What would you like? Would you like to play football? Or finish the last course of Powerslave? And then we'll do something else. Like I say, we apologise for the interruption to your normal services. I haven't got a fucking clue what happened. I can't be fat with the power stopped. No. What's wrong with this? Is that the right time? Alright, that's a clue. Who runs the last course of Powerslave? Who wants to start the next song? It's a referendum, isn't it, really? He's got the right guitar now. He's just changed guitars. Are we ready? Are we ready? I think we're ready. Where's Dougie, our sound engineer? He's out there somewhere. Dougie, is that you? Down for Christ's sake, everybody else. Good God, I can't see the man. Put your arms up, Dougie. That's it. You see him with the two arms up? Get him. Are we ready? Excellent. What are you doing now? He's changed his guitar back again. It's not called Julio Wanty for nothing, is it? And so can the power failure. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, I do apologise for the interruption to the proceedings. Normal service has been resumed. You may now officially go absolutely fucking raving mad. Thank you.
Yeah!
Dave Murray on the tube.
And finally, last but not least, there has to be in every band one of these. And they're all barking mad. Mr. Nico McBride on the drums! Tonight's been a great night. It's been a great night for Metal. It's been a great night for Maiden to be back in New York City. Another sold out Madison Square Garden. Back to New York City, we're going to try and do something a little bit special. Let's just maybe try and sell out more than one. We already played to nearly 50,000 people in the New York area since Meadowlands and this one and PNC last night. So next time we come back here, it's a date. We'll see you with a brand new fucking Iron Maiden album, all right? We'll see you real soon. So then we're going to leave you with a little surprise. Well, not a little surprise, it is a surprise. I don't know. 7 deadly sins, 7 ways to win, 7 holy paths to hell and your tree begins. 7 downward slopes, 7 bloody hopes, 7